Hello students, welcome to Marine Engineering Tutorials. I am Atul Kumar Gupta and back with a new tutorial. We are presently studying marine boilers. Today we have 9th lecture and the topic is type of superheaters. Superheaters are used to drive the steam turbines which if driven by saturated steam would be damaged as its blades get eroded due to water droplets in wet steam. This tutorial does not discuss about the superheaters used on earlier smoke tube boilers as low pressure smoke tube boilers are not used for driving steam turbines nowadays. Superheaters the most delicate component of the water tube boilers because specific heat of steam is less than 50% that of water, which makes it very susceptible to overheating and subsequent damage. Thus, superheater has to be protected from the intense heat of the furnace, which is achieved by having several rows of large diameter screen tubes before superheaters. Superheaters are broadly classified in two categories, namely integral and external superheaters, as used in different make of the boilers. Integral superheaters are close to the furnace and sandwiched between generating tubes. On the other hand, external superheaters are fitted on the exhaust side of and are well protected against overheating. This sketch shows an integral superheater used on D-type boilers placed between generating tubes and secured with superheater support plate and header support lugs. It consists of two headers in which U-tubes are attached. Each header is equipped with a baffle plate due to which steam takes 3 passes through flue gas passage before it leaves the superheater. So we can see here the steam which enters from this connection. Here we have a baffle, so it takes a pass, goes to the outlet header. Then again we have a baffle here, so it goes up and goes to the upper tubes and comes back to the inlet header. And then it goes up from the upper tubes, goes to the other side and goes out from the outlet pipe. Headers are equipped with hand holes for getting access to the tube internal, steam inlet and outlet connections, safety valve, vent and drains, etc. Let us see various components on the sketch. First of all, we have headers, these are the two headers. Then we have U-tubes which are attached to the headers. Then we have superheater support plate by which it is attached. Next is locating lug for placing it in position. Then we have baffle plate, two in numbers, one on outlet and one on inlet. Then this is the header support lugs. You can see here, this is to support the header. Then we have hand holes, which are opposite the tubes to get access to the internal. Then we have drains on both the headers. Then we have a drain hole in the baffle plate so that the condensate can go to the bottom and can be removed from the drains. Then we have saturated steam inlet at the bottom. We have superheated steam outlet at the top. We have a safety valve, then we have a thermometer pocket, Then we have a vent on each of the header. We have a steam connection which comes out from this manifold for soot blowing purpose used in the boiler. This is a Kawasaki boiler which has used the vertically arranged superheater tubes which are parallel to the screen and generating tubes and are attached to horizontally arranged headers at the bottom. This arrangement provides better drainage of the condensate, and in the following slide we can see a double superheater which has better control of superheat. So in this modern boiler, the burners are given on the roof and the flue gas is passing over the screen tube, then through the superheater. This is the main generating bank, and before leaving it passes over the economizer where field water is heated, and then goes to the air heater where combustion air is heated and it leaves the boiler uptake. D-type boiler is equipped with two superheaters, which is a common arrangement in most of the modern boilers for having a better control over the degree of superheat by using a temperator between them. So we can see various parts illustrated in this diagram. First of all, we have steam drum, then we have water drum, then this is the furnace on the side of the drums. Then number four is the main generating bank, which is consisting over here, attached between the two drums. Then we have a header for screen tube connecting between the steam drum and this header. Next is, there are three rows of screen tubes. Then this is the inlet header, or we can say primary superheater inlet header. Then we have the primary superheater coils. Next is primary superheater outlet header. Between the two superheaters, we have a device known as a temperator, whose purpose is to control the final degree of superheat. Then we have the inlet header for the secondary superheater. Then we have the secondary superheater coils. Then we have outlet header for the secondary superheater. And we have the superheater support. Also, you can see superheater support on this side. Then we have superheater support tube, which is taking the weight of the superheater. This type of superheater is used to obtain varying degree of superheat by regulating the quantity of gases passing over the superheater and the remaining gas over the saturated steam section by gas damper. So what we can see here, that the depth of the furnace is divided in two parts. Half of the part is taken by the superheater and the other half has saturated steam section. As superheater coil does not get full length of the boiler for heating, it is made of W-shaped to provide the required heating surface. Wider tube pitch reduces the possibility of soot deposits. Headers are arranged vertically, whereas superheater coil is placed horizontally perpendicular to generating and screen tube as seen in the diagram. So what we find here, these are the vertical headers and the superheater tubes, they are perpendicular to the screen tube as we see and generating tube on this side. Let us see various components of this superheater. First of all, we have the headers. Then we have W-shaped tubes attached to the headers. Third is the handholds. This is for getting access to the tube internal. Then you have superheater support tubes, which are taking the weight of the tubes. There are several of them. Then we have screen tubes, three rows of tubes of large diameter carrying water, so that the intensity of the furnace cannot reach the superheater. Then we have saturated steam inlet on this side, and on this side this will be the outlet. And we have this division plate, which is dividing the gas flow in two parts, partly over the superheater and partly over the saturated section. This arrangement is used on Foster-Wheeler ESD boilers, where superheater is placed between generating tube and economizer. As it is subjected to low temperature zone, thus it is safe from the flame impingement, but it requires large heating surface area and is equipped with soot blowers to keep them clean. The tubes are supported by lugs mounted on the membrane walls. This arrangement is preferred in modern boilers. So what we can see here, this is the primary section and this is the secondary section. And between the two sections, we have a temperature, which we will study later. And these tubes, superheater tubes, they are supported by the supports here mounted on the membrane wall. And there are soot blowers for keeping them clean. And the gases leaving the superheater will pass over the economizer above it and the air heater before they leave the boiler. This sketch shows the superheater used on the Babcock and Wilcox boiler, placed between the inclined generating tube and perpendicular to them for high temperature superheating, acting like an integral superheater. So it can be used both as integral and external. Alternately, for low temperature superheating, it is placed above the return tubes, perpendicular to them and acting like an external superheater. Headers are equipped with internal baffles to provide several passes of steam flow. Usual mountings are equipped on them. So we can see various parts. These are the headers. Then we have the handholds, shown as, first of all we have tubes, part number 2 here, shown here. Then we have handholds, 3. Then we have support plate, which is supporting the tubes. Then we have superheater support tubes. So this is also supporting the tube, taking the weight of the tube. Then we have saturated steam inlet at this header. Then we have superheated steam outlet from the upper header, to which are attached safety valve and vent. And a drain is attached to the inlet header. So we have discussed various types of superheaters. I hope the concept is clear to the students. This book is written by me and covers all the topics as per Indian Maritime University syllabus. It clarifies the concepts with simple illustrations. This book also provides answer to all the questions which have appeared in the examination conducted by Indian Maritime University. This book can help the students in preparing for the exam and also to work on the ship's boiler safely. Hope you have liked the tutorial. You can write your feedback in the comment box. If you have liked the tutorial, you may share it with your friends. You may subscribe to the channel for getting notification about the new tutorials. I'll be back with a new tutorial shortly. Thanks for watching till the end.